Hello again. No intro today. You're welcome. Just curious, how old are you? And you ask because I talk about final exams, but also said I was in my 50s in the crash landing video. Yeah, I see a lot of age questions, even on the previous video where I talked about graduating. I wanted to answer one to clear it up. I suppose I should finally come clean. I am actually 37. I often lie about my age as a running joke, like I just did. I'm 21. I'll be 22 in the summer, if you believe that. But it is the truth. I know graduating doesn't give that away. You can go back to college at any age. But I think I also said something about how I've been in school my entire life. Yeah, my age isn't meant to be a secret. The boomer sour meme originates from the fact that for a long time, I've gotten a lot of people tell me I sound older than I am, which I'll take as a compliment. I don't want to sound like a child. So when people ask how old I am, I'll throw out a random number as a joke. But I felt bad after that crash landing one, because when I brought it up in relation to human reaction time, like you mentioned, saying, oh, my reaction time isn't as good anymore now that I'm in my 50s, well, I was deflecting the fact that my reaction time was pretty average, and I knew you young folks would want to flex your quick reaction times on me, but then there were some comments, seemingly from people who are in their 50s, saying stuff like, hell yeah, brother, didn't know you were my age, keep it up. Oh no. Suddenly it went from the running joke that I sound older than I am, to feeling like I had stolen valor, like I was posing as something I'm not. That was not the intention, and I was not making a joke at the expense of anyone in their 50s playing video games. More power to you, absolutely. But there you go. I am 21. Have I thought about being a guest on the official podcast? And I saw some other mentions about me doing podcasts in general. Well, you'll have to excuse me, I'm not familiar with that one. Not meant as an insult, I'm sure they're not familiar with me either. There are two podcasts I follow, but there are a lot of them out there, and the vast majority are very boring. Not everybody should have a podcast, and if I were a guest on one, I would only make it more boring. I appreciate that you think I might be good on a podcast, but the reality is, I'm a young guy with not a whole lot of life experience, I don't have a wealth of crazy stories, and I'm a pretty quiet person. Maybe easy to forget when I'm making a video and I'm the only one talking, but in a group of people, I wouldn't jump into a conversation with a funny quip, I would sit there quietly, which is not what you want in a podcast guest. So thank you, but no, I'm not thinking of appearing on any podcasts. If I really were in my 50s, I think I'd be a much better guest. Do you play any old CODs to this day? Generally, no. In recent years, when I finish with a game, that means I feel pretty done with it, like I've earned and accomplished everything I wanted to do, there's nothing that makes me want to go back to them. That sense of completion wasn't the case with the much older CODs, though, so there's definitely nostalgia pulling me back to games like Modern Warfare 2, and that is the only one I have played recently, because I hopped on PC to record a little gameplay for the first Q&A to have it in the background while I talked about ranking the COD games. The intro to the campaign gave me fucking chills. I didn't think it'd have that much of an effect, but I was smiling the whole time. I played The Pit for a while, and that's what was in the video, but I did also play two multiplayer games. I was level 1, so I had the good old FAMAS Grenadier default class with default streaks, but it was a lot of fun. I even got my Predator, got a Cobra in the care package. I'm not about to go grind Modern Warfare 2, because there's not much to keep me playing. There's the thrill of reliving it, but the options for mapping controls and sensitivity leave a lot to be desired in the old PC version, and the player base is obviously very small, but still, had a lot of fun for those couple games I played. What part of Canada am I from? Vancouver, my man, BC. Why do you hipfire so often and not aim down your sights? Thanks, Sergeant Foley. This was probably just a comment and not meant as a Q&A question, but it was on the video, so I'm gonna answer it anyway, because it used to come up a lot. On PC, especially, hipfiring is often the right idea. It isn't like I never aim to hit a longer range target, I aim quite a bit as well. But back when I was posting gameplay of a laser sight cordite or auger, I never understood getting this question. It should be clear from the gameplay that hip firing was the right idea whenever I did it, because it worked. It's not like spray and pray, like I'm not hitting a damn thing and it makes me look like an ass. My shots are landing. Hip firing isn't a bad idea on console either, but on PC there's less of an incentive to need to aim down your sights because there is no aim assist. You can make it so that your sensitivity is lower when ADS, But bottom line, you can track your target just as well when hip-firing, and you can maintain full mobility, which is huge, especially with something like Gung Ho in COD. You're way harder to hit when you're sprint-jumping around. It is a terrible idea to try to ADS in close-quarters PC COD. You need to be the first to start shooting, and you can do so accurately and without sacrificing movement by hip-firing. So yes, I tend to hip-fire more than you might be used to. Also, if this comment was referring to the Apex that was in that video, well, a lot of the guns in Apex have perfect first shot accuracy when hip-firing. It isn't a fully randomized cone like in COD, so in some ways, even more effective. What was my favorite DLC war map from World War II? Pretty specific, but it would be Operation Intercept, the very first one. I'm sure a large part of that has to do with the fact that it was the first one, so I was still playing a lot of war. I got really into the map, found some secret wall bang spots, tested out how to destroy the radios in the best way. I thought it was a good map. The other one that's coming to mind is Supercharge. That was a cool one. It was the third map, though, if I'm not mistaken. Right, the second map was the nighttime one, Operation Husky. I'd rank that the lowest, because I wasn't into the dogfight ending, so I never wanted to vote for it. I found it to be a bit boring, and I wanted to keep getting my weapon XP. I like that they tried something unique, though. I don't want to crap all over them for that. And then there was a fourth map, right? Yeah, okay, I had to look that up. Operation Arcane. I don't know why I couldn't think of it. I did play it a few times, enough to be able to visualize the whole layout, because I was still playing the game at that point. Usually, I'm not playing COD anymore by the time DLC 4 comes out. World War II was the exception, but I was very into shipment XP grinding at that point, and less into war mode. Arcane was kinda goofy with those injectable serums, but it was a fun map. War was a good game mode. Overall, if we aren't talking DLC, then Breakout was my favorite for sure. Can you choke me daddy? Well, you'll just have to send confirmation of your age, and then I'll provide a waiver for you to sign, and you'll have to have that notarized at your expense. And then sure, that can be arranged. Thank you for asking a question that will look funny in the title. You still enjoy BO4, but all your friends don't, and it isn't as fun playing alone. What should you do? Well, as much as you can maybe coerce your friends into trying a game that you play, if they don't enjoy it, you can't force them to. You could try to hop on the mic in lobbies and talk to people, or hop in a Reddit party up thread type of thing and make new friends who still play, but I know that isn't the same as playing with a friend you've known for years, or someone with whom you have a lot in common. You could try playing whatever your friends are playing, or play towards some kind of goal in BO4. I don't know, man, just have fun. Only you know what you should do. It's just a form of entertainment, nothing too serious. You just have to decide how you are most entertained. What BO4 mode do I feel I spent the most time on, and where did I actually spend the most time? Well, for me, those two things line up. I for sure spent the most time in multiplayer, getting that 100%er, a bit over 10 days. Then I spent 7.5 days in zombies, getting that 100%er, but there's less lobby time there, and the playing is much less active, so that did feel shorter. And I spent a bit over 4 days in Blackout. My stats are absolute garbage because there was a lot of grinding tiers in the early days, and then there was some playing for fun. Some other people did want to see final time played numbers, so I figured I should show that. What do I think of the upcoming PS5 and how well it will do? Well, I have no idea how well it'll do. I do think there is still a market for consoles, and I have to assume they know what they're doing, somewhat, to release something people will want to buy. That said, I'm not very invested or interested in buying another console. I'll keep following the news about it, but I can't think of what feature would make me want to get one. Maybe exclusive games at some point in the future, otherwise I've got my PC right here. And do I like Xbox? I mean, I don't dislike Xbox, but I never owned one, so I guess the answer is no. And related to that, do I like the Halo franchise? Well, I've played a little at friends' houses, but as you'd expect, because I never owned an Xbox, I don't know that much about it. I think I would like the Halo franchise, but I wasn't exposed to it all that much. Can you make some Apex gameplays? You seem really good at them. Well, thank you, but I'm not. I'm pretty average. Getting better, though, and I'm having fun. I don't care how good people think I am. My channel is not about showing off my gaming skills, if anyone hasn't noticed. Of course, I'll tend to show games and moments where things went well, because I think that's more fun to watch, but you'll notice my aim is often not spectacular. Anyway, when you say making gameplays, if you mean live commentate games of Apex, I don't know how to make that entertaining. I love these Q&As because I have actual topics to talk about over gameplay. I can't think of anything at all interesting to say about what's going on in the game. But I still enjoy playing it, so for now I'll keep using it as the primary background for these things. Can you explain the video creation process from idea through to final upload? For sure. It varies depending on the video, but I'd say the core of what I do here is make guides, often for challenges, and the process for that is fairly simple. I'll be playing the game, going for challenges, and if I have to devise a strategy and maybe test out a few different methods to find the best way to complete something, then I think, well, I should share that strategy so other people have an easier time with it. And I record all the clips I think I might need as I go, label them all very descriptively so it isn't a pain in the ass to find what I'm looking for later. That's a very important part. Then there's some thought that goes into deciding if it's a video worth making. Like in Black Ops 4, except the Ninja Challenge, which was big enough to cover on its own, I ended up grouping everything into the categories because I felt that made for a fun series that wouldn't drag on forever with little 2-minute videos where I state the obvious about a single challenge. After I have all that together, I don't know how much detail you want me to go into, but I'll write up the video for a guide that would be a full script, not just talking points, because it needs to be concise and organized and easy to follow. Then I'll record my voice track, edit that down, drop in all the examples I need to match what I was talking about, record all the additional clips I might need, maybe of testing something or of a menu screen, put that all together, render it out, upload it, make a thumbnail, title, description, tags, end screen, all that, and release it. That's the best part, get to see what people say about it, then do it all again. When it comes to video ideas that aren't challenge guides, they usually come from me playing a game and running into something that I think would make a fun video, or if I have some opinion I want to get out there, or there's a big game update to cover, and if I have nothing to talk about, then maybe I'll play through a campaign of some game, or do this, where people tell me what they want me to talk about. I can't say that I've ever sat down and just tried to brainstorm what video I should make. There's always been something that felt right. It sounds kind of dumb, but I don't know, I've always had a logical next step of what video to make. Alright, thank you for the questions as always. Now I gotta pack up this computer and get out of here. This was pre-recorded earlier in the week. I am right in the middle of moving, so if a COD trailer happened and I didn't say anything about it, that is why. Thank you for watching. I'll catch you next time.